So yeah, first YouTube video, right? I'm gonna try and not make this as boring and just as boring as possible. But I'm telling y'all right now, editing's probably not gonna be anything crazy. It's probably pretty bland. I'm also trying to not be a Walmart brand Sam Sulek as well. So yeah, I guess first things first, pre-workout, I got just Ghost energy drink, right? I'm always definitely more of an energy drink guy over pre-workout. Not because of like ingredients or anything like that, but just it's easier. I don't have to make it. I don't have to, like, I guess throw, I know it's extremely lazy, right? But I just don't feel like throwing powder in a shaker, I guess. And I really like the carbonation aspect to it. And the taste, I think, is a lot better in energy drinks than it is in a pre-workout. But yeah, so we got back today. I start with rear delts first, just because I despise doing them after back, because I'm honestly so tired and cooked after doing five, you know, heavy exercises for my lats. It kind of kills the vibe when you finish your back and you're just like, dang, now I have to go do reverse pec deck, you know? It's like, yuck. So I'll do the rear delts first, two things, three sets for each of them. So I get a total of six sets in. And it also kind of helps me warm up a little bit. It gives me time for my pre-workout to kind of set in. Well, I guess energy drink in this context, but kind of gives it a minute to set in, really kick in, get the music playing, really get fired up, you know? So yeah, I think my goal for this whole like YouTube thing, maybe one video a week would be cool. You know, if this actually does well or something like that. Because I don't expect anything out of this right now. Right now I'm doing this simply just for, I don't know, having some fun on YouTube, I guess. And if anyone gets entertained out of this, that'd be cool as well. But yeah, I'm not doing this right now because I'm like, oh, let me try and become a YouTuber and make money or anything like that. I don't expect a lot of people to watch this. But, you know, here we are. I actually have had a decent amount of people in the past hit me up about YouTube. And I've always liked the idea. I don't know, I just never really got around to it. I was like, I'm not a fan of like getting my camera out and setting it up and tripod and filming. I feel like awkward doing that. Like I feel bad because I know I hate it when I just dislike it when someone's like filming with a giant camera and a stand and all that, and I'm just like, you know, sitting there in the background or whatever. But I mean, it's whatever. At the gym I go to right now, it's kind of like accepted socially there. Like so many people bring a camera in there, so I'm not too worried about it. But I don't know. Just like I said, I never got around to it. Yeah, I started some Accutane, so it's kind of making me... It's honestly making my skin break out a lot right now. But whatever. Just gotta thug it out, right? So yeah, I'm doing that, but then my lips also get chapped, which is annoying. More of a nuisance than anything, you know? But I mean, if it'll help clear up my acne, then I can't complain. I just genetically, I don't know, I've had it since I was like 13 or something. If anyone's wondering, this is the Vase Pop flavor, whatever. Honestly, I think all Ghost Energy drinks are just top notch flavor wise. They definitely stand out in that regard. For specifically performance aspect, I really like Reign. It has a little bit of extra caffeine in there, a little extra 100 mgs, 300 opposed to 200 in the Ghost, and that gives me a little extra boost, you know. So if I'm going for like a PR or, you know, I'm really want a heavy hardcore day, I go with the Reign. But just in general workout, I go just for a Ghost. I also don't like to have 300 mg of caffeine on a regular basis. I kind of like to keep that special. I would like to keep it as low as possible so I can get away with the least amount of caffeine. You know, the last thing you want is to be having to drink two, potentially even three energy drinks to feel anything. But also, I mean, it messes up your sleep if you're consuming copious amounts of caffeine. And that's something I do not want. There was a period for like 6 weeks I got this pre-workout that was kind of, it was a little potent, right? Every time I would take it, I just couldn't sleep. And for some reason, it just didn't click in my brain that it was the pre-workout that was making me not be able to sleep. So I would literally just keep taking it every day for my workout and just having bad sleep over and over and over again. Until finally I was like, hold on, let's think about this rationally for a second. My rest days I can sleep fine, but my training days I can't. What's the difference? Caffeine, you know? So yeah, I figured that out, and I literally have a couple scoops of that one left just sitting in my house, but I'm not taking that because I really do value my sleep. I would say sleep is definitely one of the most undervalued things when it comes to building muscle, getting stronger, all that good stuff. Just recovery in general. And even just general mood. Like, if you get 8 hours of sleep, or a substantial amount of sleep, you're going to feel significantly happier than you would if you're just on, like, sub six. Yeah, a lot of guys take that for granted. They, you know, get in, like, sub 6 hours of sleep and think that caffeine just makes up for it, but it really doesn't. I mean, sleeping is when you recover, right? So what's the point of going and destroying your muscles and getting in the protein if your body can't even recover from it? Just my two cents on it. And I guess to go into that, if we're gonna go down that ballpark, gotta prioritize your nutrition as well. Not just the macros. That's something I was confused with for a very, very long time. My first couple of years of training, I thought it's just all about the macros. The Greg Doucette, if it fits your macros, you're chilling, right? No, definitely not. There is a major difference between eating protein that comes from ground beef, chicken, fish, red meat, white meat, whatever, than opposed to like protein bars. You're going to get, It's night and day difference. Are those like Fairlife protein shakes? Yeah, I guess I'm the one to say it. Those things are, it's not, you know, it's not the same as real food. Yeah, real food's always gonna win. When it comes to nutrition side of things, you can't expect the same results if you're eating just fitting the macros. You know, there's also micronutrients, vitamins, all that good stuff that's in the real food that you don't get when you eat processed / you know, macro foods per se. Yeah, I mean, it takes more time, sucks cooking, but that's just the name of the game, man. You gotta put that time in, you gotta do it. Bro, get like 8 chicken breasts, cut them in half, throw them on a pan, and throw it in the oven for 30 minutes. I mean, do the same thing with ground beef. Like, get a giant pot, throw like 15 pounds in there. I mean, that's what I eat in a week. I eat 15 pounds of ground beef, but obviously I don't think y'all would need that much ground beef, because I eat about 2 pounds a day. And obviously, you know, you can meal prep rice. Rice is like the easiest thing to meal prep. Just giant pot, boiling water, rice, boom. You're good for the week. Time you're actually spending cooking the rice is like, what, 10 minutes? The majority of the time it's just sitting there. So yeah, it sucks, it's boring, but it's the name of the game, man. You can either, you know, give it 50% or you can give it 100%, but I know what I'm doing. I'm doing 100%. I know I'm probably talking to pretty like educated people that are already dialed in, but if you're not doing the solid 8 hours of sleep, meal prepping your food with whole foods, or just getting in whole foods, give it a shot, man. I'm telling you, you'll recover better, stronger, everything will be better. Literally, there's not one negative side effect to that. Everything better. As you can see, I have a very jaggedy setup here. It's literally just my... But y'all get the gist of it, right? I mean, Sam Solek filmed with this like iPhone for quite some time. So so I'm not really too worried about all this stuff. Oh my gosh. Now I do the mandatory time of listening to music and just getting in the headspace. Because if you're not going into your workout with that intensity and with that drive, what's the point, man? What's the point of giving 10% of it, you know? Gotta get all you got, and to do that, you have to be in the right headspace. So, time to get dialed in.
People think you need to control the concentric. That's just not the case. You want to control the eccentric a little bit, but you do not want to slow down on the actual contraction of the muscle. You want to actually power through it, then control on the way up on the eccentric, but always power through the concentric. Two sets there, just till failure. Doesn't really matter. I just kind of do that to one, warm up. And two, I don't know, I wouldn't call it pre-fatigue because I still feel fine. But yeah, now we're going into T-bar rows. All right, I didn't video it, but I did 4 1/4 for 8 reps, 6 to 8 reps, something like that, I can't remember. But now, back down, 3 plates 1/4, hoping for at least 12, and then a drop set, a little double drop set right after it. So this is gonna be a wicked set.
Yep.
Let's go. Come on. Nice. Come on. Up. Let's go. Come on, Matt. Come on, Matt. Let's go. Come on. Yeah. Come on. Up. Come on. There it is. There it is.
Where was Jordan his it?
Fire? Yeah, fire.
Good, bro. As y'all can see, that last set was pretty nasty. And the pump was there. Pump is there for sure. But now we're moving on to some prime rows. And yes, I know this is practically the equivalent of nails on a chalkboard, but gets the job done. That's what matters.
Stop!
So got those prime rows done. Now we're gonna run into some cable pullovers. And like I said, guys, everything's two sets, still failure, some drop sets here and there. But main focus is, you know, slamming that intensity in as ramps as possible. Force reps, all that good stuff. That's how you grow. The more you put in, the more you get out. Simple, that's all it is. So now we're going into some cable pullovers. Just get a good burn, pump, whatever. But main thing, train hard. You know I ain't come to play with you. Snapping up the rear, don't say I'm a favorite. Ha! Probably don't want it, so baby, mama, take a chick. Cause I'm the type of baby that's gonna fuck the baby. See the eyes, don't put up ass on the hate. Do you think you see me? They got bags on these rappers, rappers. Put in 40 out of get out of angel with them. All them moves and whoever they got hanging with them. Workout complete. I did a little double drop set on that pull down, just regular lat pull down, whatever, close grip. And then the double drop set, just empty the whole tank. Posing's looking nice. One of my lats is kind of wound up. Probably need some body work or something of that sort. But honestly, I'm liking the way things are coming out right now. Looking nice. Subs are kicking in, you know, getting stronger. So yeah, what more can I ask for? Right now we got cardio, 10 minutes of interval cardio on the bike, and then 20 minutes on the treadmill. Just regular treadmill, 2.5 speed, 10 incline. All right, post-workout, guys. Workout complete, cardio done. Did a little bit of sauna, I don't know, like 15 minutes, something like that. I don't really track it. I just kind of go in there, right? Post-workout meal, we got it right here. Some protein powder, some cereal. Both just fast digesting things that are gonna fill up my glycogen again and get some protein in the system, get me recovering, because that's where you grow, right? Now, is there enough evidence to conclude that the anabolic window is real, like directly after your workout? No, but it's definitely not gonna hurt, I'll tell you that. But post-workout, you don't really want any fats. You want something that's gonna speed up your digestion. Fat, slow digestion, right? So you're trying to replenish as fast as possible. So you want like a easy digesting carb as well as protein powder, both those very quick. I mean, it doesn't have to be protein powder, it can be chicken, just like a lean meat, you know? At the end of the day, if there's one thing I would like for y'all to take away from this video, it all comes down to what you put in, what you get out. You know, anyone that tells you can grow off of eating three meals and protein, the protein shakes and all that, is all your meals for protein shakes is just as good as real food. Disregard everything they say. Instantly disregard everything they say if they think you can only eat three meals a day and still grow maximally, right? I mean, you may still grow, but not to the same degree that someone's eating five meals a day, five plus, you know? If you're only doing six sets or something like some of these optimal guys doing, or keeping reps in reserve, like two RIR on their sets, no, that's not how it works. I mean, simple, what you put in is what you get out. The harder you train, the more results you're gonna get. There's no way around it. All this like science-based crap about having reps in reserve and you can only recover from three sets, well, no one actually says three, but you get what I'm saying.
it's just, it's a load of baloney, you know? Now, keeping that in mind, I'm not saying go and do 20 sets a week per muscle. That's obviously a little bit excessive. But I would aim for like the 10 to 12 sets. I do about like 10 sets every 5 days for my chest. So I would kind of run something along those lines. Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't get 15 plus. I think that's a little bit excessive. But definitely if you keep like a 10 to 15 sets, even for smaller muscles like rear delts, I only directly train my rear delts 6 sets every 5 days. So I'm not saying you have to do, you know, 20 sets to grow. That's definitely not true. You'll probably be hurting yourself a little more. I mean, maybe, but just somewhere in that ballpark, you'll be fine. And that's, I mean, that's sets that are till failure. A lot of them are, you know, drop sets, extra forced reps in there, stuff that's going to keep you, keep the intensity even higher. For the main way you should structure your training, let's just say for a given muscle, like, I don't know, back for say, since we did back today, I pick 5 exercises, 2 to 3 sets each, and I keep those 5 exercises over and over on weeks on end until I plateau on exercise and I can't go up in weight, can't get any more reps, and then I'll cycle it out for something else that's kind of in the same motor pattern. But I like to have a pullover in there. I like to have some sort of heavy row, whether it be like a T-bar row, barbell row, Smith machine row. I like to just have some sort of chest supported row, a cable pull down, and then just some sort of like machine pull down or something like that, right? But you want to keep the same exercises and keep progressing on them. That's how you're going to get stronger and bigger. If you keep cycling out exercises every single week, how do you know if you're getting stronger if you can't gauge your training? Because that is a big thing, is training is a very key indicator of muscle growth. If you're getting stronger, you're getting bigger. There's no way around it. Probably cut the video here. If you stayed this long, I really do appreciate it, because I know these clips are probably extremely boring. I mean, it's probably gonna be even boring for me to go in there and cut it. Yeah, I hope you guys learned something. I hope y'all enjoyed watching the back day. And if you like it, leave a comment down below or something like that, you know, tell me what I can improve upon, because that's another thing I'm trying to learn with you guys. I'm still kind of new to all this content stuff. I'm really not that smart when it comes to all this. So yeah, please drop a comment down below what I can improve on and how I can get better at all this. Peace.